Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. I get a lot of people who send me emails, call me, say, Dennis, I don't have a lot of money, but I got a lot of problems in my room. And we all know from past videos and things that we've done and talked about that small rooms have big problems. Big problems always take large amounts of surface area. Large amounts of surface area costs a lot of money. So what can we do? I'm going to break some of these videos down into three different parts, 1,000, 2,000, and 3,000, and we'll talk about some kind of treatment options that you have and things that you can do yourself. The big thing about all of this is the DIY, doing it yourself, because with $1,000, $2,000, $3,000 in a budget, you're going to have to contribute your own labor. You can buy the materials to build the technology under our supervision, but you're going to have to contribute your own labor. Obviously, if I build it for you in my shop, I have to pay my guys, and the product prices go up, and you can see those on the website. But the goal here is to treat your room with at least some attempt to get things realized and working for you. So let's work with $1,000. We have $1,000 for treatment. What's going to be our focus? Well, we remember from past videos that we have two issues in our small rooms, pressure and reflection. We know that the energy below 100 is what we're going to call low, and then this pressure we're going to call mid and high. So we have the reflections off the surface, and we have the pressure from all this low-frequency energy that won't fit. So if we only have $1,000 to work with, even if you have $5,000 to work with, the emphasis always has to be on the low-frequency first. If you do not get the low-frequency right in your room, you just simply won't have good sound, period. I don't care if you have the highest and best gear in the world, if your resolution is wonderful, if you're emotionally connected to the music through your middle and high frequencies, when that low frequency note hits, when that bass note hits, it's going to blur and smear everything. So you're going to then not play that recording, turn it down all the time when that's coming in, get EQ into the circuit, which is its own set of issues. So the bottom line is we've got to manage the pressure. Why? Because we have fundamentals and harmonics that we have to deal with. We may have a 40 cycle issue, which is 80, 120, 160. See as it bleeds through the mids. Always when we're trying to treat low frequency pressure, we have to use the acronym TAP, type, amount, and position. What type of treatment, how much, and where are we going to put it? All these issues have to be resolved first. Just building something without knowing why you're building it, which we see all the time. I just saw a project in Israel today that beautiful theater, hundreds of thousands of dollars spent. No care and concern for the low end of the room. 10 or 15 speakers, it's an Atmos system. No concern at all for the low frequency energy, and the client can't understand why it doesn't sound good. So the theater's done, hundreds of thousands of dollars have been spent. What do? We got to tear it apart. Not the most pleasant thing in the world. So what are our types when we're dealing with pressure, low frequency, membrane, Helmholtz, and diaphragmatic? We all know those from past lectures. We know that this is our area of specialty that we've chosen to develop. And we've taken the diaphragmatic absorption process, which has been around for years, and then we've added our carbon technology to it. So it has the most absorption, the highest rates and levels for the smallest amount of space, compared to membrane and Helmholtz. Helmholtz is, as we know, frequency specific, hard to get, hard to tune. You need a lot of them for all the frequencies. Diaphragmatic is broadband. Membrane is broadband also, but just doesn't have the horsepower that diaphragmatic has. And then when you add our carbon technology to it, you can really increase the horsepower by up to 30%. And we can license and sell that to you. You can build the cabinet yourself and we can sell you the carbon. So first thing we want to do with $1,000 is build as many low frequency absorbers as we can. Most small rooms take 80 to 120 square feet. Each 2x4 foot unit is 8 square feet. So you can see you're going to need 10, 12, 14 units. So with $1,000, we might be able to build 3 or 4 to get started. it's a start. Get them in your room, see how they work, hear the difference they make. Walk around your room, you'll be able to know immediately where you need them. So if you have $1,000 for treatment, we need to focus on the low end first, and you're going to have to do some DIY stuff, and we can offer you the plans and even our proprietary carbon technology to assist you. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button so you can book a appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.